So the next concept is capillarity. In Latin word, capillar means hair. That means there is a path or a tube which has the thickness of the hair. Through that, there is a rise in the water level. This phenomenon is called capillary rise. The rise of water through a thickness of hair is called capillary rise. That means there is a container which is filled with a liquid. I have dipped a cylindrical tube which has the capillary rise exactly in the middle. So this is the cylindrical tube. But capillary rise like this, very thin, almost equal to the thin of hair, thickness of hair. To show clearly, I am drawing in this much of dimensions, but it is very thin. Capillar means the thickness of hair, means that much of thickness, that much gap, simple. So when it is dipped in the water, through this gap, there will be a rise in water up to a certain height. This property is called capillarity. The ability to rise the water towards the heights through a capillary cross section is called capillarity. How much height it will reach? What is the reason for the rise in the water level? It is nothing but the change in the pressure. That's why in before cases we have discussed about the change in pressure inside the liquid and bubble. So once it is a circularly polarized, means this hole is equal cease to be circular. So the excess pressure in circular is P minus P naught, that is equal to 2T by R. Now we should find out this T and R by taking some assumptions in the help with the help of trigonometry. So this is a cylindrical tube which was dipped in the water. So at point B is the least point of the water level, means highest point of the water level. So from this also the water has rise to a point, this one A. At this the pressure is P naught and it occupies the shape of meniscus. In this case, what we can understand is it occupies the shape of meniscus. Up to that, we can find out the rise in the height level. So for that purpose, I am taking this meniscus as the reference. So the radius of the meniscus is like this, A, and I am drawing a tangent to find the angle of contact. So the tangents dimensions is R. So from this one, cos theta is equal to A by R. So therefore, it is like this. But excess pressure P minus P dash is equal to 2T by R. So we can write 2T by, from this R is equal to A by cos theta. So I am substituting R is equal to A by cos theta in this expression. Therefore, 2T by A by cos theta. We can write this one as 2T by A secant theta or 2T cos theta by A also. But if you go to the gauge pressure equation, the change in the pressure levels, the change in the pressure at different heights is equal to h rho g. So therefore, P minus P naught is equal to H rho g, and this H rho g is equal to 2T cos theta by A. Now, if you want to find out the height reached by this water level through a capillary section, H is equal to 2T cos theta by A rho g. So, height reached by a fluid through a capillary rise section is directly proportional to its surface tension, inversely proportional to the radius of the capillary section, inversely proportional to the density, inversely proportional to the acceleration due to gravity. More density, height reaches less. Less density, more height. So this expression can be written like this also. H is equal to 2t by secant theta a rho g. So like this also we can define. Now we will discuss a numerical based on this. So this is a numerical which is based on the concept of capillarity. The content is, what should be the radius of a capillary tube if the water has to rise the height of 6 cm in it? Surface tension of the water is 7.2 into 10 to the power of minus 2 newton per meter. So we should find out the radius. So the height should be 6 cm. Nothing but 6 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. Surface tension T is equal to 7.2 into 10 to the power of minus 2 newton per meter. So we should find out the radius. But in the previous equation, the radius of the capillary rise we have thought is A. So the expression H is equal to 2T cos theta by A rho g. Now we should find out this A. So we can write this equation like this also. 2t cos theta by r rho g, where r or A is equal to radius. So r is equal to 2t cos theta by, what is this h rho g? It's a vertical rise. So therefore, we can say the theta is equal to 1. So 2 into surface tension is 7.2 into 10 to the power of minus 2 by H is equal to 6 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Density of water 1000 kg per meter cube. G is equal to 9.8. 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 2 gets cancelled. 6 7.2 1.2 times, therefore it is 2.4 by 1000 into 9.8. So we will get 0.245 into 10 to the power of minus 3 meters. It is approximately 0.245 millimeters. So this should be the radius of the capillary tube for the rise of 6 centimeters. So in this lesson, we have started with the different properties of fluids, and we have finished the Bernoulli's theorem and its equations and examples, and many physical phenomena of fluids like viscosity and surface tension. So with this problem, I am concluding this lesson.
If you like this video, please give a thumbs up. Please subscribe to our channel to get more videos on CBSE syllabus.